much fast I will complete this session, and so that first of all, I would like to thank Principal Ma'am for giving this opportunity to conduct, present. So this topic is helping adolescents thrive on insight on psychosocial intervention in promoting mental health. Okay, so this is the topic. So here, how we are going to give psychosocial intervention, how we are going to promoting the adolescents' mental health. As we know that, that is, adolescent is the most crucial period. Yes, and because the adolescent is the most vulnerable group, they are more susceptible to develop mental illness. So here, that is, half of the mental health conditions, that is mental disorders, they are having the onset, that is during the early adolescence period itself, they are having the mental health problem, and that suicide is the third leading cause of death. So here 9% of the death, it is occurring due to suicide. So that's why here this is adolescent period is the one of the most public, that is it is one of the public health concern, that is public health challenges, because during the adolescent period only they are having all the that is fast physiological, rapid physiological, psychological, social, sexual changes happening in their body. So that's why here the risk taking behavior also involved more in this stage. So here, the because of this risk taking behavior, the morbidity and mortality rate of adolescents' mental health problem has been very much increased. So here in this 21st century, here the adolescent mental health is the major public health one, and so we are going to see. We know that mental health. So what is mental health? As we know, the mentally healthy people, how they will be? They will have more positive, they will be very happy, they will do more physical activities, they will involve themselves in more physically, and they will maintain good healthy relationship with each other, and they will have, they can relax, they know how to relax, they know how to, they will have good sleep, adequate sleep they will be having, and they will accept the disappointment. So this all we know what all the, how the mentally healthy individual will have. So now we will see about the what are the common triggering factors. So these are all the common triggering factors. It's increase the adolescents to undergo more stress. So due to that, here the adolescents are developing the chance to develop the mental illness. So here they are developed, that is exposure to adversity, peer pressure is one of the major thing, and exploration of identity, because the, during the adolescence period, adolescents wants to establish their identity. It's one of the challenging for them. So violence, harsh parenting, severe socio-economic problem, media influence, either it will be enhancing or either it will be so it's both positive is there, negative also is there. So, and poor quality of home life, and they have not having good relationship with their family members, and stigma, because the adolescence period, most of the adolescents, they are not ready to seek. So they will have more stigma. So due to that, they are undergoing more risk. So that's why these are all the common triggering factors. So what are the problems of mental health in adolescents? As that is the emotional problem. Emotionally, if you see, they'll have more depression and anxiety will be the most common one. Because of this depression and anxiety, here the adolescents, they are not difficulty to concentrate on their studies. Because of this not able to concentrate, here their school performance is very much going down, and the loneliness, they are developing social isolation, withdrawal, these all the symptoms they are developing. And behavioral problem, as we know, behavioral problem here mainly risk-taking behavior. Adolescents are more involving in highly in the involving risk-taking behavior, such as alcoholism, substance abuse, self-harm, these all the things they are involving. And scholastic, because here their perform, that is in school also here they have a difficulty to concentrate, so their performance is very much reducing. And identity, as already mentioned, in the family also, if they have any family history of any alcoholic father, or they are not having good family relationship with the family members, so they are having the sibling problem, they are not having good relationship with the sibling, and environmental problem, that is interpersonal problem, they are not able to maintain good interpersonal relationship with the others, infatuation, this all the problem will be developing, love affair during this period, and social factors, social crisis, financial difficulties, this all some of the problems make the adolescents to develop problem during the adolescence period. So these are only some of the adolescent psychosocial problem. So what are the psychosocial problem means here? Drug, that is, as we know, it's all self-explanatory. Alcohol use, abuse, eating disorder, suicide, runaway, homeless, death, antisocial, involving in more antisocial behavior and violence, drugs. These are all some of the adolescent psychosocial problem. So here, because of this, here the adolescents are going into the poor mental health. So they are developing emotional disorder, as I mentioned, that they are having more anxiety, depression, suicide, self-harm, risk-taking behavior. They are more commonly, they are developing eating disorder, anorexia nervosa, bulimia nervosa. It's all associated with the depression, and also it's this reason they are developing more death also. Suicide is more commonly occurring because associated with the depression. And psychosis, because that is half of the mental health disorder, they are having the mental illness, they are having the answer during the early adolescent period itself. So here they are developing hallucinations, delusions. It's all due to this, here the adolescents is having the difficulty to participate in their activities. It's affecting their activities, and substance abuse, alcohol, and exposure to violence. Here, because of this violent or destructive activities, the conduct disorder they will be developing, and they will be having involving themselves in more criminal activities also. And high risk behavior, as you know, that is risk taking behavior, substance abuse, more commonly they will be engaging themselves. So because of this, here their education is very much affected, and so because of the, and also here associated with, they are developing teen pregnancy, domestic violence, child abuse. So the physical fight more commonly they will be having during the adolescent period, and they will involve in crime activities, homicide and motor vehicle crashes, this all. So because of the poor mental health, so these are all the some of the challenges. One, that is adolescent challenges area, they have, that is adolescent crisis, temperament problem, internet addiction and substance abuse, drug abuse, smoking, bullying. So they are having more commonly, they will have emotional disorder, that's why they will have develop depression, juvenile delinquency, that's conduct disorder, self-injury, eating disorder, suicide, adolescent obesity and gang formation. This all more challenges area. For these all the problem, how we are going to help the adolescents, that's what we are going to give. How we are going to give intervention, psychosocial intervention, here we are going to give. So that's only we are going to see. So these all the common adolescents problem. Now we are going to see the how we are going to helping the adolescents thrive. That is, we have to promote the positive mental health. So we'll see how we are going to promote the positive mental health and prevent the mental health conditions, prevent the self-harm and other risk-taking behavior. So this is mainly we have to focus. If we focus this, majority of the, that is, morbidity and mortality rate would be minimized. If we focus more on this area, and also it helps to, we can promote the mental health of the adolescents, and with this we are going to improve the lifelong well-being of the adolescents. And the major aim of WHO, UNICEF is at the year of 2030 we have to reduce the suicide mortality rate. So the major vision of the WHO, UNICEF here, that is, we have to be, that is, join with the, that is, with the family members, with the caregivers, with the with the civil society, with the community, with the joining effort, we have to promote the adolescent mental health and prevent the mental disorder, and also we have to focus on the lifelong well-being of the adolescent. That is the major vision of the WHO and UNICEF. So we will see how we are going to promote the positive mental health, that is healthy sleeping pattern. We have to maintain, that is regularly they have to follow the time period. So regularly they have to go to the bed, they have to switch off the gadget before going to the bed and wake up at the same time, we have to follow. And exercising regularly, I think if you do exercise, definitely what happens, endorphin will be releasing, so it will release the tension. So it will enhance the mental well-being and developing the coping strategies. How we can develop the coping strategies? So whenever you are getting the stress, we have to involve yourselves in doing some other activities. You can play or you can recreate yourselves which you are liking. You can draw, you can do some exercise, yoga, deep breathing exercise, or drawing, painting, whichever you are liking, you can create yourselves. With that you can develop the coping pattern. And problem solving, you have to sort out the problem, what are the problem, you can do some brainstorming technique. So with that, what are the possible solutions you can able to solve, you can solve. If whatever it's not able to solve, you have to accept it. And interpersonal skill, you have to develop the good interpersonal relationship with the everybody, with the family members, with the neighbors. With that you will develop the strong support system. And learning to manage emotion, here whenever you are getting the, because emotional regulation is the major one for the adolescent. So what you can do now, whatever the emotions it's coming into your mind, that is anxiety, anger, that is irritability, so it's all negative emotions it's coming, you just can have a regular time period you can set. For example, 5 to 5:20 you can allow, you can create a daily, whichever time, this is a particular time I can create for that whatever emotion it's coming into my mind. Then you can write it down. After writing, so what you have to do, you remind yourselves that I have written everything now. I can focus on doing my work. Then what you can do next is, you just allow only for a particular period of time. Rest of the time you can enjoy it. So this is also one of the way you can manage your emotions, and you should have the protective, supportive environment. That is major important. These are all the way you can promote your positive mental health and the strategies that promote mental health. You should have the positive self-talk. Always you should say that I can do, I will do my best. If I am not, who will? So that kind of thought always it has to come to your mind. I will keep on working. I'm doing everything in right. I am good enough. So these all the positive things, always it should come to in your mind. Definitely it will promote the positive mental health. And you have to be careful how you are talking to yourselves, because you are listening. So that's why always you have to talk positively. Then the menu of calming strategies. This is also one of the way to promote the mental health. Be aware of unkind mind. That is the negative thoughts will be coming now. So I cannot do, I am useless, I am having fear. So like that type of thought is coming now, you change the negativity into positivity. Always you should talk, that is self-talk, in positive way. And power, you have to change the thinking pattern into positively. And mindfulness breathing, always you have to focus on your attention, what is happening in the current moment. Okay, and take a mind walk. Whenever you are getting some negativity, anything it's coming into your mind, so you can have a mind walk, or you can go to some, even you can with your sitting place, you can imagine what it is coming, good golden moments happened, so that you can think it off in your mind. And yoga, movement, these are all the menu of calming strategies when you are having anxiety or any irritability or any negative emotions it's coming into your mind. Then this is mental health promotion. So that's what already we have discussed, how you have to regulate emotion. Alternative to risk-taking behavior, that is many ways are there. Either you can do exercise or either you can do deep breathing exercise, progressive muscle relaxational techniques are there, or drawing, writing, whatever you are liking, so that you can do. You can involve yourselves in some activities, physical activities. So with that way, it's one of the alternative way to come away from the risk-taking behavior. You have to build resilience. I think morning session, Srinivasan sir has spoken very well about this. And you have to promote supportive social environment. Network has to be given for the adolescents. Understanding the importance of mental health in the school. Why? Because school is the place where they are spending most of the time. The children are spending more time in the school. Always we have to create the school environment in more positively. Then only what happened? And they will be understanding it. So what all we have seen initially? What all the emotional problem, behavioral problem, poor mental health, now how the children will be having, that's all we have to explain. Training has to be given to the school teachers, so it will be very useful to prevent the adolescents' problem. So these are all some of the protective factors. That is positive. Always we should have the positive mental health. So when we have a positive mental health, when you are thinking everything in positively, definitely the children can perform their studies very well. And you have to create the taste of the studies. So automatically the child will get high academic achievement, and the child, they should develop good family relationship, family belongingness, love and affection is very important. And the involvement, make the child to involve themselves in more religious activities, spiritual activities, relaxational training, self-monitoring. They itself, they should aware about themselves. That has to be created. Then only they will be knowing what they are doing. What is their aim? All those things they will be knowing. So we'll see what all the preventive interventions according to WHO, here they have given. So they have given that universal preventive interventions. So what is the universal preventive intervention means here? Universally, everybody, that is, we have to focus intervention for the general public mental health education has to be given. At the same time, in the school curriculum also, they have to include the substance abuse, because that is the, because of this substance abuse, when the child is involving, that is the major risk factor or causative factor for educational difficulties. So that can be implemented. And selective preventive interventions, mainly selective intervention has to be given if the child has exposed or undergone any domestic violence or any violent in that situation, we have to give support. Group has to be there and they have to give intervention. And indicated preventive interventions, that is those who are having high risk individuals who are having emotional behavioral problem, for them we have to give some social skill training. That is how to maintain socialization, then coping mechanism, coping, that's all the things we have to focus. And treatment, those who are having diagnosed that they are having the mental disorder, definitely we have to give psychosocial interventions like individual psychotherapy, group psychotherapy, family psychotherapy, evidence-based practices and all can be given. So these are all the, according to WHO, this is the preventive interventions mainly has been given. So that is mainly what you have to do means here, how we have to prevent the mental illness. We have to create awareness to the public, awareness to the community, and all the professional also, they should be knowing. Now we all are healthcare professionals, so we all studying in psychiatry subject also, so definitely we should know. Then only we also can give, create awareness to the public and early identification of the problem. So what are the warning signs of the adolescents? That's all we have to teach. And social understanding, reduce the stigma. Early they have to come for treatment. They are thinking that if we are having mental illness, if everybody knows, they are thinking they are feeling very low. So that has to be removed first, then only they will seek treatment. So we can prevent the mental illness. And what all the, make them to recognize what all the future initiativeness is there for them. So now how you are going to support your adolescent mental health? See here, you have to encourage them to share their feelings. So here you have to encourage, you should encourage them to, you sit with them. you ask the, you sit with your children and you can, they can share their feelings, acknowledge their emotions, understand their emotions also. So this all, even though sometimes they will be doing what they are doing, you are not liking also, but still you have to encourage what they are doing good. So that you can do, and you can take the time to support. So here togetherly you can sit and collaboratively you can work together to achieve the goal, and you can support in that is because we as you know, adolescents wants to be independently, they want to do. So we have to give little time and space for them also. It's quite natural only. So that also should be there in our mind, and you have to be help them to support in their homework or so their school work. So that aspect also we have to support and work through the conflict together. So here, what are all the conflicts are there? First, we have to sort out their list of their conflict is going on in their mind. Sort out their conflict. What all the possible solutions can be given? So that you can teach to them, and we can develop some coping. That is, still they are having some anxiety also. Here we can do some calming practices. They can do relaxational. They can do some breathing exercise that they can do, and care for yours. So if the caring for yourself is very, very important one. We will see how we have to take care of ourselves. So bibliography, that is, they can read some good book, some motivational book, some positive thought books and all, they can read very well. So affirmations, that is encouragement. That is, emotionally you can encourage them. Meditation they can do. Solve some of the relaxes. They can take care of themselves. Guided imaginary. That is, whenever they are feeling more stressed, they can have guided imaginary techniques. They can feel wherever they have gone, it was happened in their life. So that they can think it off in their mind. So it's all release the stress. Workbook activity they can do. Breathing exercise they can do. They can have send some good messages. At the same time, they can receive some good messages. See to that, because we are using more mobile gadget, so always we have to use good things. For that we can send message, it's nothing wrong. And self-care treatment and healthy friendship we have to maintain. And here the adolescent has to involve himself in more ritualistic activity. They can, whenever they are having more stress or anything, they can involve themselves in more pet activities and spirituality. These are all some of the self-treatment and take care of ourselves. So, and also some of the other more tips also is that they can do some maybe repeating, they can do exercise, they can light a candle, that is aromatherapy. You can have whichever flavor you are liking, that you can have it. It's all will make you to feel more fresh and calm your mind and reduce your caffeine. Write it down whenever you are having more anger or aggression. So you can just write it down, that one, and you can. So that negative, that anxiety, that anger, everything will go. It will release. And chew gum, because when you are chewing gum, your brain will be more active and you will feel more fresh. Spend time with your friends and family whenever you are getting time, and laugh. So it's laughter therapy is the one of the good exercise to relieve your anxiety. And learn to say no, because adolescents are undergoing more risk-taking behavior. So we should teach the assertive training. It is more important one, and they can have some attend or yoga classes, practice mindfulness, cuddle. So that means they can have with the family members, kissing, so that is loving, that's all they can express. With, listen to the soothing music, deep breathing, they can spend time with their pet, eating healthy foods, that is very, very important one for the adolescents, because the adolescents, they will have more health problem, because of that they are developing more, that is eating disorder, so they have to take care of very well. And regular sleep pattern they have to follow, and if they are feeling any, if they are having any problem, they should ready to seek the counseling also, and learn to avoid procrastination. Then and there, whatever work they want to do, they have to do it. They should not let us postpone it, later I will do. So that kind of attitude mainly we should not encourage. So these are all the some of the tips we have to take care of ourselves. So now this is the helping adolescent thrive. According to the WHO, UNICEF, here they have given some of the strategies. So the first one, that is implementation and enforcement of the policies and laws. As adolescents, here what all the policies or laws is there? So here that we have to be implement it with the help of multi-sectoral collaboration. That is multiple sectors and the stakeholders with them. We have to implement at the state level, national level and the local level. And here the environment to promote and protect the adolescent mental health. That is school-based mental health education we have to give. That is family-based mental health education. In family we can give all the therapies. Individual psychotherapy, group psychotherapy, family psychotherapy we can give. Community-based activities here, more religious activities, spiritual activities, make them to participate so that they can have the drama, dancing, whatever activities in their community, make them to participate in the social activities. So all will be promoting the mental health and physical, that is physically make them to be more alert. So then caregiver support, that is very very important one. The caregivers, mainly they are the one taking care of the adolescent. They should know what is the caregiver's knowledge. So that's all we have to teach to them, and we have to support the caregivers. We have to praise the caregivers also. Relationship building, mainly we have to teach about the relationship building to the caregivers, and the caregivers also, they should take care of their own mental health. That's also we have to be focused. Then last one, we are focusing on adolescent psychosocial interventions. That is what next we are going to be. So why we are having the that is psychosocial interventions also will be promoting the adolescent's mental health. So what is psychosocial intervention? So the psychosocial interventions means, so now, so far also we have seen, these are all the way also we are promoting the adolescent mental health. But once the adolescent has developed mental illness, definitely we have to go this psychosocial intervention, because it will be more effective one. So it's defined as, that is interpersonal, informational activities, techniques or strategies that target the biological, emotional, behavioral, cognitive, interpersonal and social factors with the aim of improving the mental health functioning and well-being. So for that only here we are focusing this psychosocial interventions. So these are all the components mainly they are focusing. That is emotional regulation, all the points almost we have discussed. So these are all the components of psychosocial intervention. Emotional regulation they are focusing, problem solving, how we have to maintain the interpersonal relationship with each other, because that is very important for the adolescents, and mindfulness practice, assertiveness training and stress management techniques. So these all the things they are focusing under the psychosocial interventions. So what is the effect or benefit of giving the psychosocial interventions? Because these adolescents, when they are undergoing or receiving the psychosocial interventions, it is most benefited for them. They will engage in the community, they will involve in the community participation or activities. Their symptoms will be very much reduced. Their satisfaction will be, life satisfaction will be there for them, and positively they will think about themselves, and it helps to intimate the peer relationship, and their quality of life will be very much improved, and they'll have more spirituality and participation in the school work and assigned tasks, and they'll have a quick recovery if they are developing any mental illness also, and they'll perform their daily living activities more effectively, because these all the effect will make the individual to overcome with the risk-taking behavior. So that's why here we are giving the psychosocial interventions for the adolescents. These are only some of the, that is otherwise we can call it as a non-pharmacological therapy, psychotherapy, that is called talk therapy or counseling we have to give, psychodynamic insight-oriented therapy, behavior therapy we are going to see, and cognitive behavior therapy, self-treatment. That self-treatment only already we have discussed. So that is psychotherapy. Here psychodynamic, that is mainly your individual psychotherapy. Here mainly we have to focus on how to solve the problem. That is how they can take decision making, communication, make them to aware about themselves. ourselves. Insight mainly we have to create by giving the individual psychotherapy and decision making, problem solving, this all the parts mainly we have to focus. And here psychoeducation, that is psychoeducation mainly we have to give to the caregivers. It is very important knowledge, especially about the emotional problem, behavioral problem, what all the warning signs, this all we have to teach to the family members, to the caregivers. Especially we have to teach to the caregivers, and we have to show that is if they are in their family, if anybody is having, their children are having any mental disorder also, we should not blame their children, rather they have to give more support, love, kind enoughly they have to treat the children. And also the, with the same problem, if any children or any families are having apdina, we have to show, then only they also will be understanding, and mutually they will be the mutual understanding, mutually they will accept that problem also, they also will be knowing how to take care of their children. In that aspect we have to focus. And also psychoeducation you have to give in the main aspect of dealing with behavioral problem, that is you should teach, that is when you are giving teaching, you should teach to the caregivers that what you are allowed to do, what you are not supposed allowed to do, that clear cut you have to explain. And you simply when you simply and clear expect clearly you have to tell them that what they can do, what they are not supposed to do, and that's we have to teach. And you have to sit with them, you have to talk with them, you have to give opportunity for the adolescents also to talk what feelings they are having. These all the things we have to teach to the caregivers. And also mainly you should not give any physical punishment. If you are, rather you can focus on the that is withholding their rewards. So that aspect mainly we have to focus. These are all the way you have to educate to the that is how to overcome with the behavioral problem. And as well as they can go with many self-care treatment, we have seen that aspect also we can teach to the caregivers. Then for the emotional problem, how they can overcome, in that aspect also you have to focus. That is regularly they have to go for sleeping regularly, which time sleeping time schedule you have to create, how when they have to go for sleeping, when they have to go for eating, when they have to go for playing and reading, these all the things they have to make a scheduling time. Stress reduction technique, how they have to reduce their stress, and that's all we have to teach in order to overcome with the emotional problem. And that is behavioral therapy. In behavioral therapy mainly they will be having, it is called behavioral modification. In behavioral modification they will be having more, that is unhealthy destructive behavior, we have to change the healthy constructive behavior technique. In that only one of the technique, that is cognitive behavior therapy, we have to, that is mainly we have to focus on, that is cognitive restructuring, that is you have to give, you have to identify that is negative automatic thoughts. They will be having, always they will be talk about that I am useless, I am boring, I am not at all useful, I will not have any good future. So like that type of thought they will be having, this is called distorted thinking or maladaptive thinking or undesirable thinking. So this all the thoughts has to be modified and we have to change. Here for that, here what you have to do, you can use this distraction technique, that is counting the thought. They can have a diary, they can write it down how many times it is coming, how many times they are thinking about it, and they are having that is they are thinking that they are useless. So in that what you can do, you can give some activity, make them to do, that is monitoring activities and scheduling the activities and graded assignment. If they have done it good, we can encourage them, and we can give some play activities, so that all the things we can focus on giving the cognitive behavior therapy. Then then that is family therapy. That is family therapy. Mainly, you have to focus on giving family. That is how they are. What is the communication pattern? How they are maintaining the relationship with the family members, with the siblings, with the parents, with the grandparents. All those things we have to focus, because that is very, very important one. How they are talking, what they care in the family, they are having certain rule that is set and limitations will be there. So that's all clear cut. We have to talk, and it should be known to the children also. And school-based interventions, that is school is the place, school mainly for the teachers, we have to give training regarding what are the adolescent's problem. The school teachers should know, we have to create the positive environment in the school. The children should feel happily to go to school. Like that way, the school has to be created. And also here, we have to give peer leadership training. We have to give how to maintain good peer interpersonal relationship in positive way, early identification, early intervention, and early reference services has to be done in the school. So that aspect we have to be focused. And reality therapy, here we should make the child to realize what is the realistically they can do, what is the what is the realistically they can do, plan the schedule in the realistically way, and they have to do carry on the work according to that or go ahead it. In case if any plan they have done, if it is failure also, but still they can make it new one and they can proceed it. For that also we can do some encouragement. So and social skill training, that is very, very important one. The child has to develop good socialization. They should know what is the verbal, non-verbal understanding in their, and they should maintain good interpersonal relationship. They should maintain, when they are talking, good eye contact with each and everyone. How clearly verbal message they can give. So these all those things we can focus in the social skill training. And main thing you have to focus on listening skill. The adolescents will not, that is a major problem. When we are giving teaching anything also, they will not listen. So the listening skill mainly we have to focus, and in the social skill training and interpersonal psychotherapy, when you are giving interpersonal psychotherapy, mainly you have to focus on individual problems. Mainly you have to address what all the problematic behaviors are there, that we have to identify when giving the interpersonal psychotherapy. Group therapy, that is group therapy, the commonly we can make the each adolescent to sit together who are having the emotionally ill problem, and they can interact with each other. So when they are interacting with each other, peer interactions they will be developing, peer support they will have, and also they will be knowing, that is they will be knowing how to overcome this emotional difficulties. These are all the way it helps to overcome their emotional problem, and it is one of the effective way have changed their personality also in positive way, and it will all boost up their self-confidence, self-esteem level. So these are all the some of the psychosocial interventional aspect we have to focus. And that is last, that is minding your mental health. So you have to stay informed, but set limits for news and social media, because there also they are learning more negatively rather than positive one. So they should know what is the, as Trustee Ma'am Morning mentioned, 75% is bad, 25% is good. So what is good, that we have to take it and keep up your healthy routines, all the routines. It, as adolescents, is more important one. Even most of the adolescents are sitting here. You should plan what is your sleeping time, what is your reading time, what is your playing time, all those things. You should make a schedule and stay connected to others and try to anticipate what all the distress you are having. So before itself you should anticipate. If you are having also, you should get support from each other. And smoking, drinking, you should try to avoid, and make yourselves eating for comfort. So adolescents, they will not eat properly. Always you should maintain your health. You should eat well balanced diet. In that aspect you have to focus, and don't make assumptions. Okay. And online phone support you can have only on the, that is good thing you can have. Chariya. So this is some of the awesome words. Worry does not empty. That is tomorrow of its sorrow, it empties today of strength. So what is a misuse of imagination? So always you should have a gratitude is the key to happiness. Always you should have a gratitude. And always you should be happy, not because everything is good, but because you can see the good is everything. Whatever you are seeing good, you should show that you are very happy. So your mind will feel you are positively. When you are feel more positively, so you will feel yourself always high self-esteem. And to manifest your goal of happy, meaningful and fulfilling your life also, you will feel that you have good meaningful life. And if you are concerned about your child mental health, definitely you have to start to talk with your child. That is very, very important one. And always you can have a be grateful, so you can enjoy your little things also. Even today you came here for the conference, so you should feel that your college has sent you for here, so you should be grateful for that. You are having grateful to attend this session. So each and every moment you should feel, you should make a diary, you should write it down before going to bed. You should see what all the things today you got, great things happened in your life. Always it make you to be more feel happy, and your life will be also will be very good. So thank you for the opportunity. Thank you, ma'am. I'd like to thank our principal ma'am for giving this opportunity to talk this session. I hope I have covered this, what all the soil interventions will be very useful. You don't leave this message with this hall, then it will not be useful. If you implement that, definitely it will be very useful, not only for you are going to deal with all the public. So I hope you all has to be implement into your practice, not only for you, even it will be for me also. Thank you, ma'am. This opportunity to honor the beloved Professor Jamuna Rani with token of love.